The cabinet was out of the country to get their perceptions out of the way.
Troops are in the air for possible riot control.
The telephones didn't work to get the wrong stories from spreading if anything went wrong with the plan. Nothing was left to chance. He could not be allowed to escape alive.
Oliver Stone's controversial new film charges there was a conspiracy to kill President John F. Kennedy. And JFK is one of the movies we'll be reviewing this week on Siskel and Ebert, along with our final report on an unscientific survey about who should play Rhett Butler and Scarlett O'Hara in the sequel to Gone with the Wind. I'm Roger Ebert of the Chicago Sun-Times.
And I'm Gene Siskel of the Chicago Tribune. And my bottom line on JFK is that it is full of questionable material, but also full of undeniably compelling entertainment. As director Oliver Stone sees it, the Kennedy assassination was a coup d'etat of mammoth proportion involving everyone from the CIA to LBJ to munition manufacturers to the media. Leading the crusade for truth is Stone's idealized portrait of New Orleans District Attorney Jim Garrison, played by Kevin Costner, in another one of his latter-day Jimmy Stewart roles, here talking to his staff.
We're talking about our government here.
No, we're talking about a crime, Bill, pure and simple. Y'all got to start thinking on a different level, like the CIA does. Now, we're through the looking glass here, people. White is black, and black is white. Just maybe Oswald is exactly what he said he was. A patsy.
What is remarkable in the film is Stone's recreation of time and place. Here as Garrison and his investigator speculate at the Texas Book Depository window about Lee Harvey Oswald's marksmanship ability.
FBI tried two sets of tests. Not one of their sharpshooters could match Oswald's performance. Not one. And Oswald was at best a medium shot.
If not Oswald, who was responsible? Well, one of Garrison's investigators says the crime is a mafia hit. Garrison disagrees.
Could the mob get the FBI, the CIA, and the Dallas police to make a mess of the investigation? I mean, could the mob get the Warren Commission appointed to cover it up? Could the mob wreck the autopsy? I mean, could the mob influence the national media to go to sleep?
On a strictly movie level, JFK is full of fantastic characters and performances, most notably Joe Pesci as a New Orleans lowlife who may have been involved, but only, he says, as a stooge, like a lot of others, including Jack Ruby, who, of course, killed Oswald.
And who killed the president?
Oh, man, why don't you stop it? This is too big for you, you know that? This is, who did the president? Who killed Kennedy? Man, it's a mystery. It's a mystery wrapped in a riddle inside an enigma. The shooters don't even know, don't you get it?
JFK is full of exceptional sequences of filmmaking. It made other films I saw the same day, and I saw one before and one after. They seem very small indeed. I think Oliver Stone has a right to interpret history any way he wants, history that is especially disputed. I think he might have served his film a little bit better by labeling his Jim Garrison character as Jim somebody else. That one change might have shown that he was aware of exactly what he was doing. And some of the speechifying at the end of the picture is too purple for my taste, but on balance, I admire this film, Oliver Stone's nerve, and I can't understand why anyone would want to miss it or miss the opportunity to debate it.
To debate it and to come out and to talk with a great deal of exuberance and controversy about what's in it.
Exactly.
I found this film exhilarating.
Me too.
And you know, I've read a lot of attacks on it. They've been attacking it now for months. One of the Newsweekly said, well, he'll confuse people because he shows you scenes that aren't real and makes you think they are. And they cited as an example the scene where a cop takes a palm print on the rifle off of the hand of Oswald's corpse. Now, how many people in the theater are going to think that a real cop would pose for the motion picture cameras while he's falsifying evidence? I don't think so. I think intelligent moviegoers are capable of looking at this movie and knowing exactly what Stone did. He took real footage. He took fictional footage. And a lot of it is speculative.
Yes,
in other words, Garrison's imagining different ways the same things could have happened.
What if?
And it's exhilarating for us to follow that thought process through to the end, even if at the end we still don't know who killed Kennedy.
I think that what he is saying, really, I think that included in the conspiracy is the American public, in the sense of not demanding more.
Yeah.
And here's a guy who feels, hey, look, I went to Vietnam. I have reason to believe that the whole Vietnam experience was caused or could have been averted if Kennedy had lived. Not sure, but could have been. Maybe a better chance than with LBJ running the ship. And therefore, I laid my life on it. I have the right to make a film about it, too. So on the right basis, I don't think that should be disputed at all. And it's very entertaining. And you know what's going to happen? I think that a lot of the great performances in this picture are going to get swallowed up in controversy, and they won't realize they're really performances, and they won't get nominated,
because
and they should
they
be.
Because they seem too real. But you know, a lot of the stuff that is real in this film is fascinating, too, and especially his use of the Zapruder film, the man who made the home movie of the assassination. Right. And you look at this movie, and you find it hard to believe that one of the bullets didn't come from the front.
At the same time, Roger, it's worth discussing because I have been reading a lot about this over the 20-some
years. Oh, yeah, that
years.
It's a nervous twitch theory.
No,
yeah,
there's more
yeah.
than there's a nervous twitch. There's something about exiting propulsion and stuff.
Yeah.
But let's talk about
but
it.
But you're right about one thing. Well, we're both right about one thing. It's a terrific movie. It really is a terrific movie-going experience.